Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel Online Study Anywhere Anytime. In this video we will discuss about technical terms of stone masonry. The meaning attached to some technical terms used in the masonry are given in this video. Some of these terms are common in stonework as well as in brickwork. The remaining definitions for brick masonry are given in the specific video. So let's start. First term is natural bed. The building stones are obtained from rocks. These rocks have distinct plane of division along which the stones can easily be split. This plane represents the natural bed. In stone masonry, the direction of natural bed should be perpendicular or nearly so to the direction of the pressure. In this image, you can see here load is in downward direction. So, this is there are two position of natural bed. So this is the incorrect position of natural bed because it is parallel to the direction of load, and this is the correct position of natural bed because this is the perpendicular to the direction of pressure. So direction of natural bed should be perpendicular or nearly so to the direction of load or pressure. Next term is sill. The bottom surface of a door or a window opening is known as a sill. In this image you can see this is the window and bottom surface of this window is known as sill. Sill stones are so dressed that they prevent the entry of water to the interior of the building. Next term is corbel. In this image you can see here this is the corbel. So corbel is a projecting stone as shown in this image, which is usually provided to serve as support for roof truss, beam, weather shed, etc. The corbels are generally molded and given ornamental treatment. The corbel should extend at least 2/3 of their length into the wall. Next term is course. A layer of stones or bricks is known as a course. So you can see here this is the layer of stone or bricks. This is the course. Its thickness is generally equal to the thickness of stone or brick plus thickness of one mortar joint. Next term is cornice. A cornice is a course of stone provided at the top of all. So in this image you can see here at the top of this all there is cornice is provided. Again at the top of this all there is cornice is provided. Cornice is generally molded and given ornamental treatment. It is weathered and throated to dispose of rain water. In order to prevent the overturning of the cornice, sufficient bearing and extra weight at the top in the form of a parapet all should be provided. Next term is coping. A coping is a course of stone which is laid at the top all so as to protect the all from rain water. So in this image you can see here coping is provided at the top of all to protect the all from rain water. This course is generally provided at the top of a compound wall or a parapet wall and it is suitably weathered and throated. Sometimes the term coping is used to refer to cutting of the stones by means of feathers, plugs and wedges. Next term is weathering. The upper surface of stones used for sill, cornice and coping is dressed in a sloping way so that the water may flow off easily. This is termed as weathering. So weathering means dressing of stones in a sloping way. The term weathering is sometimes used to denote the wearing of stone surface by the action of weather. Next term is throating. In this image you can see here this is the throating. It is a groove like. It's like a groove. So A groove is provided on the underside of sill, cornice and coping so that the rainwater can be discharged clear of the wall surface. It is known as throating. Next term is plinth. The projecting course at ground floor level is known as the plinth. So, this is the plinth. It is also used to indicate the height of ground floor level from ground level. So, you can see in this image, this is the ground level and this is the ground floor level. So, the height of ground floor level from ground level is the plinth. The course protects the interior of a building from rain, water, frost, etc. It is sometimes molded and given ornamental treatment. The offset at plinth level is sometimes omitted for the architectural purpose. Next term is string course. The horizontal course provided at suitable levels between the plinth and the cornice is termed as string course. So, in this image, this red line indicates the string course. Above the string course, there is a cornice. So, the levels between the plinth and the cornice is termed as the string course. It breaks the monotony of a plain surface and it is sometimes molded and given architectural treatment. The string course is suitably weathered and throated so as to throw off the rain water clear of the wall surface. Next term is lacing course. The horizontal course provided to strengthen a wall of irregular small stones is known as lacing course. So in this image you can see here, these are the lacing course. It may be in the form of either ashlar masonry or coarse rubber masonry or brick masonry. Next term is spalls. The chips of stones used to fill up the empty spaces in the stone masonry are known as spalls or snakes. In this image you can see here spalls. Spalls are obtained as a result of reducing big blocks of stones into the regular stone blocks. Next term is quoins. The external corners or angles of a wall surface are known as quoins. So in this image you can see here external corners or angles of wall surface, it is the quoins. The stones or bricks forming the quoins are known as quoin stones or quoin bricks. In this image you can see here these are the quoin stones. The quoin stones are selected from large and sound stones and their beds are properly dressed. Next term is bond. A bond is an arrangement of layers of stones or bricks as shown in image by which no continuous vertical joints are formed. The bond distributes the load coming on the structure evenly, the formation of a vertical cracks. So in this image you can see this is the unbonded wall which cannot distribute load properly, but in this bonding wall load is distributed properly. Next term is through stones. In stonework, some stones at regular intervals are placed right across the wall. Such stones are known as through stones or throughs or bond stones. In this image, you can see these are the through stones. If the wall is considerable thick, two through stones with an overlap are provided as shown in the second figure. In the second figure, you can see these are the overlap of two through stones. Next, the area covered by the through stones should be about 1/4 to 1/2 of the area of the wall surface. The through stones should be non-porous so as to prevent the entry of moisture through the wall. They should also be strong and of sufficient thickness so as to avoid the danger of fracture due to any slight settlement of the wall. Next term is jambs. The sides of the openings such as doors, windows, etc. are known as the jambs, and they are constructed similar to quoins. In this image you can see this is the door and these are the jambs provided to the door. The jambs may be either plain or square or splayed or riveted. The splayed jambs are preferred as they allow the shutters to open up at an obtuse angle and thus permit more light and air into the room. Next term is rivets. In this image you can see this is the rivets. The exposed vertical surface at right angles to the door or window frames are known as rivets. Next term is heads. In this image you can see this is the window, and the horizontal stones provided at the top of opening for doors and windows etc. are known as the heads or lintels. So at the top of this window, this is the heads or lintel. A bearing of 150 mm to 200 mm should be given on either side of the opening as shown in image. In this image you can see here a bearing of, here bearing of 150 mm is provided at the end of openings. So bearing is in between 150 mm to 200 mm. Next term is stoolings. The horizontal seatings which provided to receive jambs and mullions are called the stoolings. In this image you can see this is the stooling, and they are formed at the ends of sills, transoms and heads. Next term is labor. The projecting course from an arch or window head is known as a labor. In this first image you can see this is the arch, and this is the projecting course of arch. It is the labor. And in this window, above window, there is a window head is present, and the projecting course of this window head is the label. It is usually molded and is sometimes known as a drip stone. Next term is apex. The coping provided at the summit of a gable wall is known as an apex or summit stone. So this is the gable wall, and coping is provided at the summit of a gable wall is known as apex or summit stones. Next term is skew corbel. Skew corbel provided below a gable coping. This is the gable coping, and below the gable coping a corbel is provided. It is known as skew corbel. So this letter denoted by A, it is the skew corbel. Next term is kneeler. The coping between apex and skew corbel in case of gable wall is known as a kneeler. So this is the skew corbel and this is the apex. In between, kneeler is provided. Next term is springer. In this image you can see here this is the gable wall and this is the springer. The coping provided at the foot of a gable wall is known as springer. Next term is finial. The ornamental finish to an apex or summit stone is termed as a finish. So in this image this is the apex, and ornamental finish to an apex or summit stone is the finial. This is the finial. Next term is buttress. A buttress is a sloping or stepped pier, and it is provided to work as lateral support of the wall. In this image, you can see here, this is the buttress. Actually, it is the step pier and it is provided to work as lateral support of the wall. Next term is pilaster. A right angle columnar projection from a wall or a pier is known as a pilaster. In this image, you can see here, these are the pilaster, which are a right angle columnar projection from a wall or a pier. Next term is face. The surface of wall exposed to weather is known as the face. So in this image, this is the surface of wall exposed to weather, known as face. Next term is facing. The material which is used in the face of the wall is known as the facing. So in this image, you can see this is the stone slab facing. Next term is back. The inner surface of wall which is not exposed to the weather is known as back. So back is opposite to face. Next term is backing. The material used in the formation of the back of the wall is known as backing. So in this image, you can see this is the brick backing. Next term is hearting. The portion of a wall between facing and backing is known as the hearting. So this is the facing, and portion between the wall between facing and backing is the hearting. Thanks for watching. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.